Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here with the next update for my haul collection project pan. I don't have as much of an exciting update as I normally do, but I still have a few things that I'm rolling out in this update. So before I jump into that, if you're new here, please consider subscribing. I would love to have you in the family, but let's just jump into the first item. Also, sorry about my voice. I am losing my voice a little bit. I've been feeling a bit under the weather for the last couple of days, which is why this update is going up a bit later. But I really wanted to get this filmed today and I'm feeling better. My voice is just a bit, you know? So that's why I'm a bit raspy. I'm also filming first thing in the morning, so that probably isn't helping. But let's just move into the items. The first product that I have is my Pegasus eyeshadow by Makeup Geek. This is a single eyeshadow that is, it's a blue shade, and I'm actually wearing this on the center of my eyelids today. This one looked like this at the last update, and as you can see, I already had pan on this when I rolled it in. And with those eyeshadows, I do put a goal to use them 15 times. And at the last update, I had used it 7 times, and I have used it an additional 8 times for this month, so I have hit my 15 uses goal. I don't know how much the pan has expanded since I rolled this eyeshadow in, but I have tried to kind of work around the top bit and even out the pan a bit, and not have such a large dip. And I think I have done that, and I'm happy that I've gotten some use out of this eyeshadow because I haven't reached for this since I pan on it, so it's just nice to kind of rotate through my eyeshadows. So this one is one that's going to be rolling out, and I will be replacing this at the end of the video. The next product is also another eyeshadow, and this is one of my Chanel potted eyeshadow in the shade Fantasme. This is one of the Illusion d'Ombre. And again, with this one, I had a usage goal on 15 because these are very kind of deep shadows and they're very difficult to pan on, so I just wanted to put a usage goal. And as of the last update, I used it 6 times. And with this one, again, I have actually used it an additional 9 times to hit that goal. Again, I don't know how much progress you can see on it. There is a little bit of almost like hard pan in this, but I have been able to use it anyway, and I usually wet this when I use it, and it works great. So I do like this eyeshadow. It's more of a topper. It's very kind of sheer sparkles, but it's been nice to top around eyeshadows, and that's mainly how I've used this. Then the third shadow that is in the project comes from a palette, and it's actually one that I am trying to hit pan on because I did not have pan on it already, and it's something that I actually can visibly hit pan on in a reasonable amount of time. So the eyeshadow comes from my Deuce palette by Juvia's Place, and I rolled this in last update, and it is the shade Mont Blanc, so that is what it looked like last time. And I have reached for this 4 times in the past month, and this right here is where I am today. So you can see that there definitely is a dip. I would think that it's going to take me a little bit longer to pan on it, but I think I definitely should be able to roll this out by next update. This has not been a shade that I've been focusing too much on because I have had other similar shades, I've had other lid shades that I've been focusing on, but now I feel like I'm not quite there to focus on this one yet, but I think I'm going to get there very soon, and then I think I'm going to have this as one of my focus shades so I can roll it out soon, because I think that I'm not too far away from that pan. So let's move on to the next product, which is one that has been in here since the very beginning of this project, and that is my Makeup Forever Full Cover Concealer. I have used this 28 times in the past month, and I thought I might be able to finish this in the past month, but I wasn't able to yet. These are all the progress lines. I have not made a new mark this month because I can't really see where I am, but I have to fill this over like this quite a lot when I try to get product out now, so I am very, very close to finishing this. And honestly, I think I should be able to finish this by next update. Who knows though, there's always so much product in these type of tubes. But yeah, I use it additional 28 times, and I use this every single day as an eyeshadow primer. So I think this should be able to be rolled out by next update if I keep using it every day, which I think will be something that will be quite easy to do. Next up, we have my What's Up highlighter by Benefit. My goal with this is to reach for it 50 times. And as of the last update, I had reached for this 8 times, so I had quite a way to go. But I have definitely stepped up my usage game of this in the last month. I've not reached for it every single day, but I've reached for it quite often. And I now have 20 additional uses on it, so I have a total of 28. I haven't marked this on a piece of paper or anything, but this is how much I have left in this product. I definitely will not be able to finish it, but it's nice to know that I'm getting some progress on it, and that is what it looks like all the way rolled down. So I have 22 more uses to go on this, and I'm not sure if we'll be able to roll it out by next update, but I'm really going to try because I have used it 20 times in this past month. So if I keep up the same amount of usage, I should be able to roll this out. But yeah, I'm not gonna guarantee it. But I'm really gonna try to focus on it because it would be nice to get this out in the next month. Because if I don't, I know that I might be just like max like 5-7 uses away. And yeah, it would be frustrating having to have it in a full month just for those like low amount of usage. The last two products before we move into lip products are both blushes. These were both rolled in at the last update, and we're gonna start with this one here, which is one of my Clinique Chic Pop blushes in the shade Plum Pop. This is what this one looks like. I have used this 5 times in the past month, and my goal with both of these blushes is to use them 20 times. I'm currently panning a lot of blushes in different projects, so I didn't want to overwhelm myself and put too high of a usage goal, so I did put 20, and I'm getting there with this one, but I still have quite a way to go. But I'm not too worried about it because, again, I'm panning so many blushes that I want to divide my attention. So if I can get just like my between 5 and 10 uses out of this every month, I will be very, very happy. The other blush is my Rocket Tour blush by Benefit. I'm not doing as well with this one. I've only reached for it 3 times, and I'm actually wearing this today. Yeah, it's a really nice neutral blush, so I don't know why I'm not reaching for it more, because I thought this would be the one that I reach for more, because it is more of a neutral tone that would be nice as a switch up, because the blush that I'm panning in my year-long project pan is very similar to Plum Pop, actually. So I thought this would be the one that I reach for more, but I just reached for very cool tone looks recently, and I like that kind of pop of plummy kind of cool tone pink on my cheeks. I think though that this one should be easy to incorporate into looks, especially when I start doing more bold looks on the weekends and things like that. So I'm going to try to get, again, 5 to 10 uses out of this each month, and hopefully be able to roll it out in a couple of months' time. So the last 3 products are all lip products. I'm going to start with the one that's been in here the longest, which is my liquid lipstick from KVD Beauty in the shade Berlin. So with this one, I wanted to use it 30 times, and as of the last update, I had used it 16. So I had 14 more uses to go, and I am happy to report that I was able to use it an additional 14 times. I didn't wear it as a full-on liquid lipstick that many times. I mainly wore it as like a stain, or I dabbed it out and topped it with a lip gloss, things like that. But it was something I got used out of at least, and it is now rolling out. I'm happy to be getting some use out of my liquid lipsticks because I have a lot of them. I did do a massive declutter of them earlier this year though, so I don't have as many as I used to, but I don't reach for them too often unless they're on projects. So I was happy that this was rolled in, so I was able to get some decent use out of this one, but I'm now going to put it back in my collection, which I'm actually quite excited about because it's definitely more of a summer shade than an autumn shade. And as you know, we're almost in October now, which is crazy. But yeah, this one is now rolling out. The next lip products have been in for 2 months now, and that is my Chanel Rouge Coco Shine in the shade Boy. My goal with this is to use it 50 times, and for the last update I had used this 18 times, and this month I have reached for it an additional 21 times. So in total I have reached for this 39 times now, so I'm getting closer to that 50 use mark. And I think this will definitely be able to roll out my next update because I only need 11 more uses. This one is a very nice moisturizing kind of sheer lip color, and as you can see, it's already quite a nude shade. It's definitely my lips but better kind of shade, and it's easy to throw on, especially if I'm wearing more of a bold eye look when I'm out and about, because usually on camera this one doesn't really show up that much, but it's perfect to pair with bold eye looks in more real life, because then something bolder like what I'm wearing today will definitely stand out more. So I definitely think that I will be able to roll this out, and it's something that I really enjoyed reaching for, and it's just something that I can reapply several times in a day, so it's not going to be a hassle at all to use this the additional 11 times. Next up we have the lip gloss that is in this project at the moment, and that is my Maybelline Color Sensational Shine Gloss in the shade Cashmere Rose. With this one again, I want to use it 50 times, and I have reached for it 8 times in the first month, so not great, but I am panning glosses in other projects. I'm currently working on 2 additional glosses, so I have to divide my attention, and I'm really trying to finish up one of my glosses in my 21 in 2021, so that's been my main focus, and I think once that's done, I'm going to start focusing on this more. So I don't know if this is going to be rolled out by next update, but definitely in the next 2 months, hopefully, if I can finally finish that other gloss, because it feels like it's never ending. But yeah, I'm gonna aim to get this out in 2 months' time. But it's nice to have a gloss like this because it's very sheer, but it's nice as a moisturizing gloss, or just to add on top of, for example, that liquid lipstick that I mentioned before, things like that. So I'm enjoying it. I just, like I said, have been dividing my attention between other things. So it's time to roll in some things to replace my products that I rolled out. So I have 3 products rolling out, 2 eyeshadows and 1 lip product. So my only goal really is to not have more than 3 things in each category. So if I roll more than 3 things in each category, I'm going to re-roll. Same thing if I roll something that is in a different project. But we're going to go ahead and randomize. I currently have between 1 and 1052. So we're going to go ahead and randomize the first number. And that is going to be 442. Okay, so 442 comes from my Club Nebula palette by Kaleidos, and that is the shade Astro. That is an exciting one because it's something that I can pan on, and I think it's like the duochrome blue, like blue to purple, so that's going to be exciting. I might be wrong though, but I think that's what it is. So let's go ahead and randomize the second one, which is going to be 90. I think that should be one of my ABH shades. Okay, I know exactly what shade this is. This comes from my Anastasia Prism palette, and it is the shade Sphere, which I know what it is, and you probably know what it is too if you have that palette. But yeah, that's going to be rolled in. And that also means that I have my 3 eyeshadows. I'm going to take them out on my spreadsheet and start my randomization from where my eyeshadows end. So let me go and check. There. So my first number will now be 796. And my max will still be 1052. So let's go ahead and randomize the third item, which will be 870. Okay, so this is actually one of my foundations, and this comes from the brand Lumine, which is a Finnish brand, and the foundation is the Blur Foundation in the shade zero Light Ivory. So we're gonna get those 3 items, and I will be right back. So I'm back and I have my 3 items. We're going to go ahead and show them in the order that I rolled them in. So let's start with the shade that comes from my Club Nebula palette by Kaleidos in collaboration with Angelica Nyqvist. So the shade that I rolled in is Astro, which I believe is the center shade, and it is. It is this kind of blue to purple duochrome. I don't know if you can pick up the shift on camera. Usually I can pick up the shift with the window that's on the side. I don't know if it's the left or the right for you guys. But it's no sun yet, it's very early in the morning, so I can't really show the shift, but it goes from like a blue to a purple. I will swatch it out in a second. But yeah, that is the shade, and as you can see, I already have 1 pan in this palette. So my goal with this would be to pan as well, and I don't think it's going to be too difficult, because hitting pan on the shade Nebula, I realized these pans are too deep. And I think this could go really well with a lot of the cool toned eyeshadows that I'm panning at the moment. So I'm excited about this one. And it is a beautiful shade, you can see it there on my finger. The second item comes from my Prism palette, and that is the shade Sphere. And again, if you know this palette, you know what shade it is, because it's definitely the brightest shade in the palette, which is this yellow right there. My goal with this would be again to pan on it, because I don't have pan on it. It's probably going to be difficult, but I think this would be nice to blend out warm tone shades with. Although I'm panning a lot of cool tone now, so I don't know how that's going to go, but I swatched it out together with other shades. So that is Astro, that is the shade Mont Blanc from the Deuce palette, and then there we have Sphere. So those are the 3 eyeshadows that I'm panning at the moment, and yeah, my goal would be to pan on all 3 of these. And then, again, like I said, the last item that I rolled in is my Blur Foundation by Lumine. This is a very, very light foundation. It is the shade Zero, so I don't know how you can see it there, but you can probably see it. Little bit of foundation coming out there that is very light, and it's a little bit problematic because I literally just rolled in a fake tan in my Deco Panning Project pan, but there's a lot of air in this packaging, but I think that I'm already like down to here, so I don't have too much product left. I'm gonna have to try to get the air out because there's loads of air in here, so I can't really see where I am. But despite this being quite light, and it's probably gonna be way too light for me, especially if I fake tan, but it's still too light for me now, I will try to finish this. It will be a mixing foundation for me until I finish it or until I get into winter. But yeah, I'm gonna try to finish this. Yeah, it's nice to get this out. I really like this foundation. It's been nice as a mixing foundation, but I think it's time to work on it and move it out, especially since I rolled it into this project. So that will be my goal with this one, will be to completely finish this foundation. So my camera just died when I was swatching everything out, but this is currently all of the colored items that I'm panning. So these 3, like I said, are the eyeshadows. Then we have the 2 blushes, we have the Plum Pop and Rock Couture. And then here we have the highlighter, which is the What's Up highlighter. And then the 2 lip products, which is the Chanel Boy lipstick, and then the lip gloss from Maybelline. So yeah, that is my color story. And I just realized this is, I think it's the first month that I have only two lip products in the project. Usually because I have mainly eyeshadows, usually the first items that I roll in is eyeshadows until I have my three eyeshadows, and then I exclude them, and then I almost always roll my lip products because that's the second biggest category in my collection. But this time I roll a foundation, which I don't have too many of, but it's still exciting, and that's what I love about like this randomization thing, because you literally can get anything from your spreadsheet. But that is it for today's video. I really hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please go ahead and give it a thumbs up, and otherwise I will catch you in my next video. Bye guys.